Hey everyone, it's Will, Gamer Dad, with another video for you. So after some success with yesterday's 5th dual horror fight, I decided to challenge this pair, which is a fox spirit as well as the Akadenchu, and I still have traumatic memories of the first time I took them down. But however, this time I'm a little bit more well prepared. So we still have the same team. We use Bertrand obviously to tank hits and apply power down to the Akadenchu because it does the first attack. And the Fox Spirit, I believe, does nothing except for debuffing your team. So we cast Aurora Force. Obviously, we have our Pierce Soul Setter. Keep in mind that the first turn, you get major debuffs, both power and int on your team. And so you really want to make sure you move your main DPS to the back or leave them in the back until you need them for AF for the next rotation. Also, keep in mind that there's an AoE from Akadenchu turn 1 that can cause confusion, and so I use all Moon Realm equipment as well as relied on a little bit of RNG to prevent any sort of confusion status. Although Mario is there, and as long as she's not confused, then we do have Cure Leaf on turn 2 if necessary. So here we are on turn 3. Normally, I would have had Bertrand slower, in which case he would have taken the hit before VCing in his meta. However, he moved out because I cast Stormbite to speed up the team. So definitely use Forefather and don't use Stormbite to speed up your team until the AF. Now the most important thing here is to use Banish on turn 1 with Claude or because we need to remove those elemental shields on Akadenchu, otherwise our DPS is just not going to be able to penetrate the stiff defenses of the Raccoon. After that, it's just a matter of making sure AS Hozuki targets the Fox Spirit, as well as your main DPS, which is AS Hezimena, targeting the Akadenchu. And so with barely any time to spare, we were able to end the fight right there. So note that with AS Hezimena, as well as AS Hozuki, I built up 5 stacks, and when the time was right, I decided to start unleashing those, Rosa Espinas, or for example, the alluring arrow to kind of finish things off. So that one was pretty straightforward, actually, given the fact that I just had to play around with my team a little bit and move around some grass stuff. And the 6th pair of horrors is finally done. I'm very, very happy about that. And slowly working through the newest content. So here's the setup. As I said, Moon Realm all the way. Claude is definitely our Grasta holder and slave, and keep in mind that because we have Bertrand on the team using Overbear on both enemies, it automatically applies pain, which is not resistible, and so you don't need any enhanced pain grass that can apply pain. You can have Bertrand apply the pain for you, and then you don't have to worry about that, and you have all offensive Grasta for your main DPS. Now obviously with Bertrand, I finally have his true VC Grasta for extra HP, and Meryl's just there for support. And Foreign, I actually forgot to put in equipment, but she's not really there for DPS anyway, so we were able to squeeze through, and it might have been an easier win with her having a weapon of some sort. For your troubles, you do get Void Axe, which is guaranteed crit rate plus type damage 20%. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.